Good morning to everyone. Myself, B. Tulsi Koteswari Bai, lecturer in chemistry, Sir CRL College for Women, Eluru. In this video, I am explaining the topic thermodynamics 3. In this video, I am explaining the subtopics Joule-Thomson effect, Joule-Thomson coefficient, and calculation of work done for the expansion of perfect gas under isothermal conditions for reversible process, and the relations based on the adiabatic reversible expansion. Next, calculation of work done for the expansion of perfect gas under adiabatic conditions for reversible process. First topic is Joule-Thomson effect. The statement of Joule-Thomson effect. In Joule-Thomson effect, the phenomena of change of temperature is produced when a gas is made to expand adiabatically from a region of high pressure to a region of extremely low pressure. Such phenomena is known as Joule-Thomson effect. That is, when a gas is made to expand from high pressure region to low pressure region under adiabatic conditions, then there is a change in the temperature of the gas. Such phenomena is known as Joule-Thomson effect. This is the diagram related to the Joule-Thomson effect, which consists of a insulated cylinder. This is the insulated tube in which gas is filled. It consists of two pistons, piston A and piston B. Piston A is placed on the left hand side, piston B is placed on the right hand side. And the pressure of the gas at piston A is P1 and pressure of the gas at piston B is P2. Here we are arranged such that the pressure at the piston A, that is P1, is greater than P2. This is the porous plug, porous compartment. Porous means which consists of holes, so it can pass through the gas easily. And there are two thermometers kept near piston A and also near piston B to read the temperature of the gas. These two are not shown in the figure. In the above apparatus, a tube thoroughly insulated and fitted with a porous plug C in the middle and two pistons A and B on the sides. The pressure on the left hand and right side of the plug are kept P1 and P2 respectively, where P1 is greater than P2. A volume V1 of the gas enclosed between the piston A and porous plug C at higher pressure P1, which is forced slowly, very slowly through the porous plug by moving the piston A inwards, and is allowed to expand to volume V2 at the lower pressure P2 by moving the piston B outward. That is, in this diagram, the piston A is slowly moved inward such that the pressure does not change. Then what happens is, the gas molecules passes through the porous plug into the compartment B. Then there is the expansion of gas takes place here. So gas molecules are apart each other and expansion takes place. Hence volume increases to V2. Then the second piston B is moved outward. So the position of the piston B moves from here to here. So there is a change in the temperature found by taking readings on the two thermometers. And it was observed that when the experiment is done at room temperature, all real gases except hydrogen and helium show fall in the temperature on expansion, because this is an adiabatic condition. In this adiabatic conditions, no external heat is absorbed or heat is lost. So no external heat is absorbed, but the gas molecules undergoes expansion. It do some work at the kinetic energy, at the expense of kinetic energy. So kinetic energy decreases, hence temperature falls down. So all the gases show fall in temperature. But there is one exception for hydrogen and helium. These two gases are exceptional because these two gases are warmed up on Joule-Thomson effect. Next derivation for the Joule-Thomson effect and change in enthalpy. Since the process is carried out adiabatically, adiabatic process means no heat is absorbed and no heat is evolved. So Q is equal to zero. According to first law of thermodynamics, delta E is equal to Q minus W. Substituting Q is equal to zero in this equation, we get delta E is equal to minus W. Multiplying this equation with minus on both sides, we get W is equal to minus delta E. That is, in adiabatic process, some work is done, there is a decrease in internal energy. Minus delta E means there is a decrease in internal energy. This is because the work done during the expansion of gas under adiabatic conditions is at the expense of internal energy. So, in other words, when the work of expansion is done adiabatically, the internal energy decreases and hence the temperature of the gas decreases. So the gas cools down. Further, on the left hand side of the plug, the work is done on the system, whereas on the right hand side of the plug, the work is done by the system. So the work done on the system on the left hand side is given by, which is equal to minus P1 V1, because here we are taking the work as work, pressure volume work. So here in the left hand side, pressure is P1 and volume is V1. So here work done on the system, so here minus sign comes. So work done on the system on the left hand side is given by minus P1 V1. Work done on the system on the right hand side is given by P2 V2. So the net work done by the system W is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1. That is, total work done is given by W1 plus W2, which is given by minus P1 V1 plus P2 V2, or nothing but it is written as P2 V2 minus P1 V1. Substituting the value of W in the equation 1, we get delta E is equal to minus W. So we are replacing the value of W in this equation, we get delta E equal to minus of P2 V2 minus P1 V1. So by multiplying with minus, we get P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Further, we know that delta E is equal to E2 minus E1. Substituting this value in the above equation, we get E2 minus E1 is equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Next, on combining the two values one side and one values one side, we get the equation E2 plus P2 V2 is equal to E1 plus P1 V1. We know that enthalpy H is equal to E plus PV. So here we can write E1 plus P1 V1 is equal to H1 and E2 plus P2 V2 is equal to H2. Then this H1 comes to the left hand side, becomes H2 minus H1 is equal to 0. H2 minus H1 is nothing but delta H is equal to 0. That is, thus we can say that in the adiabatic expansion, enthalpy remains constant while internal energy changes. So delta H is equal to 0 means enthalpy remains constant. Next is Joule-Thomson coefficient. Joule-Thomson further showed that the actual change in the temperature of the gas, because some gases are cooling, some gases are warming on Joule-Thomson expansion. So Joule-Thomson further showed that the actual change in the temperature of the gas under these conditions, which depends upon the initial temperature and pressure of the gas. So they introduced the term Joule-Thomson coefficient, which explains the actual change in the temperature of the gas, which is represented by mu. Mu is represented by the formula mu is equal to delta T by delta P at H. Delta T means change in the temperature produced by change in the pressure under constant enthalpy conditions. So Joule-Thomson coefficient may be defined as the change in the number of degrees of temperature produced by drop of one atmospheric pressure when the gas expands under conditions of constant enthalpy. That is, under constant enthalpy conditions when pressure is decreased, Then there is a change in the temperature, which is shown by the value of mu. Mu is known as the Joule-Thomson coefficient. From the above expression, it is obvious that if mu is positive, when both delta T and delta P are both negative, that means that when pressure decreases, temperature is also decreased. Then these two values becomes negative. So negative into negative becomes a positive. Therefore, mu value is positive. That means that the gas cools on adiabatic expansion. Next, second condition, if mu is negative, this appears when delta P is always negative. So this appears only when delta T is positive. Delta T is positive means that is there is an increase in the temperature of the gas. So therefore, the gas warms up on adiabatic expansion. This is takes place only in case of hydrogen and helium. Hydrogen and helium have negative mu values. This is because of there is an increase in the temperature. So these two gases are warmed up on expansion at room temperature. Third condition, if mu is equal to zero, that is when delta T is equal to zero for any value of delta P, then mu will be zero. Then that gas neither cooled nor warmed up on adiabatic expansion. In short, the temperature at which the sign of mu changes is called a inversion temperature. Below that inversion temperature, that is below the value of mu is equal to zero, mu is positive, then that gas cools. Above that mu is equal to zero, then mu is negative, then that gas is warmed up. When mu is equal to zero, that is the sign of mu changes at a particular temperature, the temperature is known as inversion temperature. Next topic is calculation of work done for the expansion of a perfect gas under isothermal conditions for reversible process. Consider a reversible process. In reversible process, maximum amount of work can be obtained for a given net change. So imagine an ideal gas taken in a cylinder fitted with a weightless and frictionless piston. Because for any small change, there may be a reversible reaction. So the piston may be weightless and frictionless. And the cylinder is placed in a thermostat so as to maintain the constant temperature for isothermal process. Let the initial volume of the gas will be V1 and the pressure inside and outside will be P. So that piston is in the equilibrium state. Now the external pressure is reduced by a very small amount, say dP. Then the piston moves upward direction through a distance, say dL. Let the increase in the volume be dV, because while decreasing the pressure, the volume of the gas increases, there is a change in the volume to dV. Then the work done by this small step is given by work done in the small step. So here we write as dW. Here REV represents for reversible process, is equal to decrease in the pressure into change in the volume. Decrease in the pressure is given by P minus dP and change in the volume is given by dV. So by multiplying we get PdV minus dP dV. dP is the small change, small decrease in the pressure. dV is the small change in the volume. These two are very small values. So very small when compared to this term. So this term is neglected. Then this equation becomes dW reversible is equal to PdV. So for expansion, the work is negative. So negative sign is represented here. dW reversible is equal to minus PdV. Then the total work done by the gas during the expansion from volume V1 to V2 can be derived by the integration of the above equation. Since this is a work done for small change, So total work done is obtained by integrating this equation. Integrating this equation, we get integral of dW reversible, we get W reversible is equal to minus of integral PdV. These are the limits, initial volume and final volume. So here there is a change in the volume, but this term is pressure term. These two are variables. It is very difficult for integrating two variables. So first of all, convert this P value in terms of V. So for considering n moles of an ideal gas, which is given by PV is equal to nRT, thus P is equal to nRT by V. Substituting this value in the above equation, we get W reversible is equal to minus integral of nRT by V dV. Here n is constant, R is constant, and T is kept constant. So integral of constant is also a constant. So these are kept out of the integral. So we get minus nRT integral dV by V. This is in the formula of integral of 1 by x dx. So we get ln x. Applying the limits, we get the formula ln V2 by V1. So finally, we get the formula as W reversible is equal to nRT ln V2 by V1. The negative sign is intentionally avoided for simplicity. So finally, we get the formula as W reversible is equal to nRT ln V2 by V1, where W is the work done in reversible process, n is the number of moles of the gas, R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, and V2 is the final volume, V1 is the initial volume. This is the formula for the work done in reversible isothermal expansion of an ideal gas. Next comes adiabatic process, adiabatic reversible expansion of an ideal gas. Adiabatic process is that in which no heat is absorbed or no heat is evolved. So change in the heat will be zero. Heat is represented by a letter Q. Delta Q means change in the heat, which is equal to zero. Since adiabatic process, there is a no change in the heat. So from first law of thermodynamics, we know that dE is equal to delta Q minus delta W, or it is written as dE is equal to delta Q minus PdV. Substituting the value of delta Q in this equation, we get dE is equal to minus PdV. This is considered as equation 1. We know that molar heat capacity of an ideal gas at constant volume, which is represented by CV, which is given by the formula CV is equal to dE by dT, or this implies dE is equal to CV into dT. From substituting this value from equations 1 and 2, that is in equation 1 dE is equal to minus PdV, in equation 2 dE is equal to CV dT. Left hand sides are equal, so we are equating the right hand sides. Then we get CV dT is equal to minus PdV. This is considered as the equation 3. Next, the relation between temperature and volume. There are two important relations in adiabatic process. One is the relation between temperature and volume. So to derive this, consider a 1 mole of an ideal gas, which is given by the equation PV is equal to RT. In this equation, P is given as P is equal to RT by V. Substituting the value of P in equation 3, we get CV dT is equal to minus RT by V dV. That is, in place of P, we substituted RT by V. So in this equation, this T term is brought to left hand side, then it goes to denominator. Then we get an equation CV dT by T is equal to minus R into dV by V. This is an equation 4. Integrating the equation between the limits T1 and T2 and V1 and V2 and considering CV to be constant, then we get CV is constant, integral of dT by T, which is given as ln T. Applying the limits, we get ln T2 by T1. The right hand side, we get minus R into integral of dV by V. Integral of dV by V is come as ln V. Applying the limits V2 and V1, we get minus R ln V2 by V1. this minus sign is kept as minus log x is written as log x power minus 1. So it is written as log v2 by v1 to the power of minus 1. So it becomes ln v1 by v2. We know that R is equal to Cp minus Cv. Substituting Cp minus Cv in place of R, we get Cp minus Cv into ln v1 by v2. Next, this Cv is brought to the right hand side, then it goes to denominator. Then we get Cp minus Cv by Cv into ln v1 by v2. By splitting this, we get Cp by Cv minus Cv by Cv. Cv by Cv is 1. And Cp by Cv is considered as gamma. Oh, while substituting this gamma here, we get gamma minus 1 into ln v1 by v2. This is in the form of n log x. So it can be written as log x power n. So this goes to the power. So it can be written as ln v1 by v2 raised to the power of gamma minus 1. In both sides there are logarithms, so we can considering anti-logarithms on both hands, both sides of the equation, we get t2 by t1 is equal to v1 by v2 whole power gamma minus 1. Then we considering the cross multiplication, we get t2 v2 power gamma minus 1 is equal to t1 v1 power gamma minus 1. That is, in the initial state and final state this product is same. So this value is constant. That value is T V power gamma minus 1 is constant. This is the relation between temperature and volume in the adiabatic expansion of an ideal gas. Next, relation between pressure and volume. According to ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Then we get a relation P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. Then this is again rearranged as T2 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by P1 V1. On equating the equations 5 and 6, we get the value as P2 V2 by P1 V1 is equal to V1 by V2 whole power gamma minus 1. This V2 by V1 is brought into the right hand side, then it becomes reverse and it is in the power of plus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 cancels, we get V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma. By cross multiplying, we get P2 V2 power gamma is equal to P1 V1 power gamma. That is, in the initial state and final state, this value remains constant. Hence, it is written as PV power gamma is equal to constant. This is the final relation between pressure and volume in the adiabatic expansion of an ideal gas. Next topic is calculation of work done for the expansion of perfect gas under adiabatic conditions for reversible process. We know that the change in the work done is equal to PdV, and also a famous relation from the adiabatic process which is given as PdV is equal to minus CV dT. From these two equations combining, we get an equation delta W is equal to PdV, which is equal to minus CV dT. This is considered as equation 7. Now suppose the volume of the gas changes from V1 to V2, then the temperature of the gas changes from T1 to T2. Then the total work of expansion during this change can be obtained by integrating the equation 7 between the limits, volume limits V1 and V2 and temperature limits T1 and T2. Therefore, integral of delta W gives W, which is equal to integral of PdV from V1 to V2, which is equal to minus of integral CV dT from T1 to T2. This is equation 8. If we assume that the value CV remains constant in the above temperature change of T1 to T2, then the equation 8 can be written as W is equal to minus CV into integral of dT from T1 to T2. Integral of dT means its value is T. So by substituting the upper and lower limits, we get the value T2 minus T1. So we get the final relation for the work done is W is equal to minus CV into T2 minus T1. This is the equation for the calculation of work done in adiabatic reversible expansion of an ideal gas. The negative sign in the above equation means that if T2 is greater than T1, then W is negative. That is, work is done by the gas, or the compression work takes place. Hence, the temperature increases, then W is negative. On the other hand, if the work is done on the gas, when W is positive, the temperature of the gas decreases, then T2 is less than T1, hence cooling takes place. These are the list of reference books for this unit, physical chemistry. Thank you.